Hi everyone, my name is George and welcome to the Anime Grove. Today it's time for Mushoku Tensei Jobless Reincarnation episode 9 reaction. During last episode, we saw how, first of all, Eris gifted Rudy a staff for doing magic, which is awesome, and it appears that it's really, really, really high end, so Rudy can cast high level spells with really low effort and using really low mana, which is awesome. But we saw how many forces were starting to move, some kind of weird child with two different colored eyes, but I doubt it's a child actually, some kind of loli, so, surely. But we saw how they were talking about someone starting doing something, or something starting, I believe, and also Perugius, the one of the three heroes, the one that defeated the press, I believe, also sensed someone trying to possibly break the seal, so he sent one of his underlings to kill everyone around, and that person almost killed all three: Eris, Rudy, and Ghislaine. But thankfully, Rudy was able to convince him that he was not involved. So he split, but right when the episode was about to end, we basically saw them get engulfed in some kind of light, in a pillar of light, maybe an explosion. And while Rudy was with Eris, Ghislaine got caught by herself, so maybe she's hurt. I really hope she isn't, because she's a fun character and I really like her. She's one of my favorites in this show, but she might be hurt right now, so it's even possible that Rudy is the one that should defend all three of them right now, in case something comes. I have no idea. There are so many things to talk about for the last episode, just like Rudy trying to take advantage on Eris, but there's not that much time. Still, I find it really interesting to see all the different possibilities that Rudy's getting, and it's sad to see that they are all going to get in the way of others. For example, Eris seems to like Rudy, but she doesn't want to do anything sexual with him for at least 5 more years. And that's great, because that means in 5 years they can. That for Rudy, I mean, that's great. But in 5 years, he's supposed to meet with Sylph, so that conflicts with what he wants. So I don't know what he'll choose to do. I hope he can somehow manage to not hurt any of them. Still, I'm wondering, will those 5 years happen during this first season? Will we ever get to see how those 5 years pass, or will the show happen during those 5 years? I have no idea. Honestly, I thought maybe the show would end on episode 11, but I think I saw today on YouTube a video. I didn't watch the video, I just saw the thumbnail and the title, something like, when will Mushoku Tensei season 2 come? So I guess there will be a season 2, that's all I know. Now let's just jump right into it, because I'm eager to see what happens. Now that the explosion has happened, is Lapras's seal broken? I have no idea, so let's just dive into it. This isn't a perfect substitute, so grab your legal copy and watch it along with me, using my footage as support for my commentary to know where I'm in the episode and what I'm talking about, but don't use it as a substitute for the original show. Now, if you enjoy my content, remember to like, comment and subscribe to join the Keepers of the Grove and help me continue growing this channel. And without any further ado, let's jump into it. Mushoku Tensei, episode 9, reaction. Go! Is this Rudy? Is this after the explosion? What is over your life? Did you die? You! Who is this? The fuck? Silver Surfer here. Is it God or something? Yeah, it is. Oh, okay, wait. The man god. Like battle god, demon god, and beast god? Is it related to that? That'd be boring. I can't send you anywhere outside this six-sided world, anyway. So they're in a six-sided world, which means it's got six sides for some reason. Like, it's a hexagon. Like, is it related to beast, humans, battles? You know what I mean. Demons. And I don't know, two more things, elves and some other shit, I don't know. But and something else, he can't send him anywhere outside. Is it because he's not omnipotent like a god, or is it because reasons? I don't know. So there are other gods. Oh! Is the dragon the last one? Dragon God? Was he the one that reincarnated him? He does seem fishy. And transported. Where is he now then? Is he away from Eris now? That sucks. So he's in the demon continent now. Oh shit. Are we going to meet these birds? Is this God, or maybe is this something planted inside Rudy's mind by that person? By the one that he's supposed to help now. The demon continent, guys? Oh shit. But then does it mean that we won't get to see Ghislaine or Eris for a really long time? Oh, she's with him. Let's fucking go. Thankfully, at least. And the staff, too. Is the man that he's about to meet her? No. It's this man. Oh, shit, that's a Sperd. Right? It had, like, a gem and green hair? No, it's not Ghislaine. Yeah. What's going to happen now? Are we supposed to help this Sperd? Yeah? Would Rudy be even able to touch this creature? I mean, are Sperds really, really strong? Besides being. Oh, he's poking in Demon God. Shit. And is Ghislaine in this continent, or is she away? Ruijerd, Sperdia? Are the Sperds a clan or something? Why does he seem so awkward? Yeah. Oh, that's really nice from him. The man whose name you already forgot. I'll have to check again. Yeah, that's true. Not like you're famous for being nice ones. See? Poor thing and poor Sperd. To have everyone feel like that, react like that every time they see you. She's so tense. Bobo bodies. It's nice that he's nice. In these cases, in many cases in anime, this would be like a wild or a savage demon in this case, and it would be hard to make them work with him, but it's nice to see that he's straight up willing to interact with them. I mean, he's nice. That's such an advantage to be able to generate water in the desert. Oh, maybe he can use his staff. Oh, they're hunting. Oh shit, that's a huge two-headed turtle? Tortoise? Oh, is it like a radar? Yeah. They're all made of, all the houses are made of turtle shells. That's really cool to see that. It's sad to know that all those shells are dead turtles, but oh, blue hair, maybe he's from Roxy's clan or something. That'd be awesome. Is he? What's the matter? He seemed afraid of Ruijerd. Or is he just, he's feeling awful because he can't let them in. All right. The Migord. Maybe he can learn to communicate with Roxy? That'd be amazing. I'd love. See, I knew they knew her. His sister? Oh, his daughter? Really? Is that Roxy's father? Amazing. Is that hemp? Wait, what? So they actually are talking in not in pure Japanese. I think they're talking like different, and that's why they have Japanese subtitles. That's really cool to have them, if I'm right, to have them make an entire side language for it. That is amazing, being honest. So much work. Yeah. Yeah, he's a Sperd. Everyone will react just like she did. Oh shit. And why is he so determined? That's what I meant. Why is he so determined to help them and not everyone else? And this Ruijerd, a swordsman, or is he a magician? What might he be? I think we saw him kill the tortoise, the tortoise, but. The. Look at the animation! So that's his real trigger. So it's the brass scheme. What happened? Oh, right. I was just asking if he's a swordsman or a magician. He just used as a trident. We just saw it. It's not a trident, but a soul? But a spear? The hero Lapras. So the heroes were Perugius, another one, and Lapras. So Lapras was a hero. Were they cursed or something like that? It appears they were, yeah. Fuck, so that's awful. So the press was behind that. Oh shit. Oh! That's fucked up, dog. Shit. The leader of their warriors. How many Sperd warriors are there left? Were they eradicated? That's so nice. After so much time trying to help children, now it's children helping him. That's so poetic. That's so nice. That's a memento from there. Let's not forget that she's a lady. This is nice, and she can get the sword now. Are those bones or minerals? Runes? What is it? That means you have changed so much, Rudy. She loves her new weapon. That's awesome. So, really nice episode. We didn't really get that much explanation on what happened during the end of last episode, but now we get some more world building, or at least me, because now I know that another of the three heroes that were the heroes, I don't know why they were called heroes though, but that unified the demon clans and gave them many rights was actually Lapras, so he was a hero. And then he became evil, and that's when Perugius defeated him and sealed him, I guess. So there's also another hero left. But he developed a scheme and was able to make all these birds look like enemies of everyone and like real monsters. But what was that for? I mean, there's gotta be a reason. There's gotta be something that explains why they were all controlled like that. What did the Lapras get from transforming them into wild killers and having their public image damage like that? I don't know, I have no idea. It's really interesting. And also, on the other hand, finally we have more Roxy content, but sadly it's her village where she isn't, obviously, but we got to meet her family, which is really, as we can see here in the title, a really chance encounter. So that's awesome that we got to meet them. And now we got new presents. Now we've got another party member. Now we have a mage in Rudy, a swordsman in Eris, a fighter maybe, or does it count as a swordsman too if it's a spear bearer in Ruijerd? And now Eris got her sword. Now it's a new sword, maybe it's a magical sword. It would be awesome to have a special sword crafted by the Miigwetch, I believe. And Rudy got some kind of runes. We already talked about them. Oh, by the way, last time I forgot to talk about this, but I think it's really interesting here in this picture. In the end, there are many things that are recognizable. For example, here we have in the upper part, I believe it's some kind of harpy, a Greek harpy, or something related to the Egyptian goddess Isis, a bird person basically. In this case, as we can see, the wings with feathers and a human head with long hair. Next to it, I thought was an amphib's vena, not next to it, but sorry, below it. I thought it was an amphib's vena, which is an animal species that actually has one head. It's like a snake, okay, but it looks like the back part has another head in it. So it looks like it has two heads, like it would be in this case, but as I later realized, there's a gap in the middle. So I don't think they're the same creature. I think they're two different creatures. And what kind of, they look like dragons, maybe? I have no idea what they might be. And below that, there are more things that might be dragons. I have no idea, honestly. More dragons here, and some kind of mouth. These are teeth, but some kind of wild monster teeth. The fangs, but I have no idea what they mean. Here we have a woman and a man. Lying, the woman is facing up and the man is facing down for some reason, I have no idea. And okay, this I have no idea what it is. Honestly, it kind of reminds me of Soul Eater, all the eye imagery and the madness that comes with it. And in the last one, we can see a mermaid and a fish person here. Here we have the mermaid, and here we have a fish person. This is the upper body part, and it's a fishes, and these are human legs, which is hilarious. And I don't know, this I might be vanilla fish in the sides. I have no idea, but I find it really interesting. And they're six. Maybe they're. Oh, I just thought of it, literally right now, that this might be related to the six-sided world, because we hadn't heard of the six-sided world up until now. But now that I realize, these are six layers. Maybe these are the six races. Shit, I have no idea, because we would have to have humans, elves, demons, at least those three, beast people. And the race that speaks battle god and dragon god? I don't know. There are like two things that might be dragons, or three things that might look like dragons, so I don't know which one it might be. But I think I've been digressing too much now, so let's just cut it short. Thank you so much for visiting my channel, and I hope to see you all in the next episode. Peace out.